You've heard of Killian Hayes, right? He's that NCAA player with the amazing highlight reel plays that leaves fans speechless. Well, he's about to get drafted top 5 just because of these amazing highlights. Well, he's also an incredible basketball player, but as fans, we love watching these college players throw down some monstrous dunks or break some ankles. Before we jump into today's video, make sure to subscribe to the NBA All-Stars YouTube channel down below. Hayes is a 6'5" player who can read defenders in the pick and roll, who can create space for himself with his dribble, who can shoot it from anywhere on the court with a defender right in his face. In practice, however, there are a few things about his game that make you wonder if he's worth choosing among the top 5 in the draft, where there are many amazing players available in the first round of the 2020 NBA draft. Hayes has a tremendous basketball IQ. When it comes to his ability to read a defense from the ball screens and choose the right pass, he's elite. He can find shooters in the weak side of the floor, he can throw pocket passes to the big rollers, he can attack defenders on the switch, and he has demonstrated the ability to be a 3-level scorer while on the court. According to Synergy's records, in 33 games played, 428 possessions ended up with Hayes scoring a basket off a pick-and-roll ball screen. That's an average of 13 ball screens per game, or one every 1 minute 55 seconds that Hayes was on the floor. So does this tell us that Hayes needs someone to set screens in order for him to score a basket? Not exactly, as these highlights that you're about to see will prove otherwise. On one hand, this is impressive given Hayes' age. He doesn't turn 19 until July 27th. He's less than 2 months older than Cade Cunningham, a potential number one pick in the 2021 NBA draft. He's younger than Evan Mobley, another potential top 3 pick in the 2021 NBA draft. While Hayes has the size to see more than one defense and dominate the smaller guys, he's not necessarily the fastest or most explosive athlete. He has a little bit of cunning, ending up around the basket on the left, and his floating game is going well. But how effective will he be as a creator in the NBA if he can't develop that right hand? He's not someone who can win when NBA defenders know what's coming. Some of this will be helped by the fact that Hayes is good at creating space to shoot dribble. Outside of the pick and roll pass, this is probably what Hayes does best. He broke several ankles, figuratively speaking of course, with step backs and crossovers last season, and his mid-range game is going very well. However, he's still not a great shooter, as evidenced by the 29.4% he shot from 3. It is worth noting that he is a significantly better jump shooter over dribbling, 38.8%, than out of catching, 22.2%. But the truth is that this is a bit worrying. The inability to shoot the catch says Hayes has a long way to go before he can play the ball. The fact that he's a bit limited as a driver and has difficulty going to his right tells me that he won't be as effective playing the ball in the NBA as he was in Germany, at least not right away. And in a 25% turnover rate, which, to be fair, actually improved over the year, and you question his consistency on the defensive end of the floor, and in that sense, Killian Hayes is at a disadvantage as a draft prospect. But that doesn't mean the potential isn't there. A weak left hand is repairable. He won't be like Patrick Beverley on the defensive side, but he has enough tools not to be a liability and, in theory, can defend any guard position. If it all comes together for him, he has a chance to be a very good professional. Will Hayes be good enough to be a high dominant guard at the ball in the best league in the world? In other words, if Killian Hayes doesn't end up in D'Angelo Russell's neighborhood, how does he fit into a winning NBA team? But let's be more specific about the numbers and Hayes' gameplay to reach a more accurate conclusion. We're talking about a 6'5", 216-pound point guard, born on July 27, 2001 in Florida, but trained for most of his childhood in France. Hayes emerged from the Great Academy of the INSEP Institute, and from 2017 to 2019, he represented his city Cholet, and then played in 2019 to 2020 at the German Ulm. There, he averaged 11.6 points, 5.4 assists, 2.8 rebounds, and 1.5 steals throughout 33 games in the different competitions of his team. It has been at the national team level where Hayes has consolidated as an exceptional prospect. In 2017, he got the gold with France, and the MVP in the U16 Eurobasket, while the following year he led his team to the final of the U17 World Cup in Argentina, losing to the United States. From here he was selected to the ideal quintet of the tournament. His numbers in that event were 16.1 points, 3.6 rebounds, 3.3 assists, and 2.7 steals. Physically, Hayes is very outstanding, with excellent height and length of arms. That height average opens many doors to his game, both as a scorer and as a passer. What's interesting about Hayes is precisely that combination of height and creation. Even without being an explosive athlete, he is a dangerous player when it comes to creating his shot, showing good handling and great effectiveness as a finisher, 58% in shooting when attacking the basket in 2019-2020. His three-point efficiency is still very uneven, but there are some signs in his favor. He takes many three-point shots, almost 5 per 40 minutes, dominates the mid-range shot and movement, and has an excellent free throw percentage, 88% in the last campaign. In turn, Hayes is also a very good passer, who at just 18 years old is the third highest average in the recent Euro Cup, 6.2 assists. He has good field vision, precision, and intuition when it comes to playing off of his teammates' skills. He is decisive and has a lot of resources to play in the pick and roll, either to generate his points or those of others. Defensively, Hayes is a versatile player thanks to his stature and with a great specialty, steals. He has averaged 2.3 steals per 40 minutes in the 2019-2020 and has had high figures in that area during his entire career. On the other hand, as weaknesses, although Hayes enjoys very good stature, he is far from being an explosive athlete. He has neither speed nor jumps from an elite level, which, although it compensates with his high technical level, could bring him some headaches in the NBA. In defense, there are some questions about his potential, since he will be at a disadvantage against the NBA athletes. And despite his height, he contributes little as a bouncer. At this point in his career, he does best when the ball is in his possession. Do you think that despite the areas Hayes might need to work on improving, could he qualify among the top 5 of the draft? Tell us what you think in the comments below. We hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure to leave us a like down below and hit the bell icon to get notified when we post new videos.